Hey guys, this hand is kind of borderline. I'm gonna run it though. I go Verdant, pass, he does whatever. Then I'm gonna go port. I'm just gonna port him, I'm not even gonna loam. If I did want, oh man, maybe I need to speed things up a little bit. Oh, that's awesome, that's awesome. Okay, change of plans. Portal. Sack. Finding. Taiga. Float. Crop rotation. Sack portal. Finding. Thespian stage. Tap for green. Play exploration. Port pass. Oh, I can port loam. That's better. So I already played my land for the turn. Oh, I actually don't want to return the portal. I'm just going to return the Verdant. Right. Alright, so we're going to have a turn two combo here. I don't know if there's a way to do that. Or I guess that'll be turn three, huh? It's not even that good. What is this deck? What am I doing? I guess I didn't have the exploration on turn one. If I'd had it on turn one, it's a different game. Needle. Well, that's really freaking good. I guess we kind of tipped our hat, huh? All right, time to dredge loam and try and find wasteland. If we can find a wasteland, we should just be able to shut them down. We didn't find a wasteland. We did find a port, though. All right, well, if I can't activate Thespian Stage, still not returning that portal. Port for turn, Verdant Catacombs. Catacombs is at least gonna get me, like, I should have fetched before I played the loam. Then the Catacombs would be in my hand right now. It's not gonna matter too much, but, so stop on the old upkeep. He's gonna sack that to map, which is fine. The only way he plays Primeval Titan this turn is if he has a show and tell, so not the end of the world. Yeah, that needle was kind of brutal. At least his naming Thespian Stage means that he wasn't able to name Rishton Port. Yeah, maybe we tipped our hand when we crop rotationed for stage. Pachuca Bog entered the revealed card zone. Alright. I see how it is. I try not to get bogged down in the details. God, that was terrible. Okay. Waste is pretty good here. Be a little bit better if we still had that loam, but, you know. It is what it is. I wonder if I'm supposed to tap the bog or just, like, start activating dark depths. Oh, the depths can't tap for mana anymore. Okay. I guess that makes things simpler. Because we no longer have the Riftstone portal. Nice. Yeah. Well, I don't know why I did that, but no worries. I'm gonna make him fetch that heath. We're gonna dredge back the loam, get back some cards. Then we're gonna go to port a heath. Cool, got that thicket. Deciding if I want to... Actually, I don't know what I'm deciding. I'm just going to play this thespian stage. Yeah, I'm just going to pass for now. I think they only run one basic forest. So he's going to get a snow-covered forest there. Now we have the option of like porting the forest and wasting the bog, or we can port the other heath. I think I'm going to port the forest just in case I'm wrong, about them only running one basic. Yeah. So our deck really came through for us here. Hitting that wasteland on time was pretty key. That we were pretty lucky to sack into another loam after we'd been bogged. If we hadn't established a lock, though, like things still would have gone fairly well for us. Not as well, but, you know. Do you want to cycle this first? Does that change anything? No, not really. I guess I play this. Oh, he does have multiple basics. Alright. I have multiple ports going, so no worries there. Oh, I should have... Well, no, I didn't. I didn't realize that I wasn't going to be able to activate the wasteland here. That's why I didn't tap that for port. Yeah, I wonder how many basic forests they actually play. I thought they had to run some number of duels for like show and tell and such. It might just be mono green. Can I pop this thing out? Is that a thing I can still do? Yeah, that seems way better. Oh, we found another port. Cool. And I mistapped, but that's fine. Should be able to cycle the tranquil thicket. Nice, spins top in response, even though he spun top last turn. Gotta check. Like, on my graveyard, it's just like a pile of nonsense over the actual stack here. Well, that's not very exciting. This game, though, I'm pretty close to just activating this Dark Depths. I maybe should have started that already. I like that we have more ports than he has lands. That's a good sign. Yeah, he needs to find a land drop and a second needle. And they run four needles, so it's a possibility, but... But it needs to be, it comes into play on tapped land, and we've already churned through two cloud posts. So we put some hurt on him regardless. Oh, there's Cavern. That could be a sign of another needle here. Yep, okay. He's going to name port. We have two options. We can keep loaming and try and find something for the Punishing Fires. Or we can just start activating this Dark Depths, which I think is pretty necessary at this point. Multiple Tranquil Thickets. I think that means that we play one of them. Because we're short on green mana. Alright, let's see what he does with his newfound freedom. Redundant top, you got it, man. Cool, there's a grove. I don't know how keen we are on that. One, two, three activations plus either Thicket or Grove to get back Punishing Fire. I think it's faster to kill him with Dark Depths than Punishing Fire for sure. If he gets a third needle down on Dark Depths, then that's going to be awkward. But we'll burn that bridge when we come to it. We're down to 20-some cards in our library. I'm still dredging Loam so that I can just get more lands into play, which speeds up the Dark Depths clock. Let's see, we have two more wastelands, three more groves, a forest. He copies a basic with Vesuva. That's funny. Do I play this? I think I do. One, two, three, four activations. Yeah, it's just not enough. Next turn, man. Next turn. It's all coming together. But we can't waste this. Yeah. One, two, three. Yeah, I'm just gonna activate it four times. I kind of think that there should be a second copy of Riftstone Portal in here. I've wanted it a lot. It's kind of like the Dex Urborg. We're still dredging, 17 cards left. We can dredge one more time at least. Maze of Ith and Glacial Chasm. God damn it. What was I thinking? Maybe I should have activated it with the ability on the stack there. Yeah, that was just bad. I guess I'll cast this. No worries, have mana to spare. We're gonna activate the Dark Depths on the end of his turn in case he plays Caracas. His best bet is probably going to be crop rotationing for Wasteland. Because if you waste the Dark Depths in response to the trigger going on the stack, it won't have the ability to resolve. It's a triggered ability. When Dark Depths has no ice counters on it, sacrifice it. If you can't sacrifice it, then you're not going to be able to get a 20-20. Green Sun for zero, sure, man. Finding Nothing, also sure. Oh, he was just using it as a shuffle effect, so he could spin top again. Looking for either Waste or Caracas, I imagine. Cool, we got there. What a miserable game. Yeah, I don't know what I want. Some Crossing Grips maybe for like tops and needles and stuff. We could Chalice on both those cards, but We're on the draw, so that doesn't seem very good to me. I think I'm just gonna like plus four of these. I think the deck needs more actual like lands in the sideboard. Like, I wouldn't mind having what is it? Riftstone portal in the board, simply so that when I have to board out cards like Maze of Ith, Glacial Chasm, Tabernacle, I can keep the land count high for cards like Mox Diamond and Exploration. Maze of Ith, not the best card against Primeval Titan. Might be better than Glacial Chasm. Not too thrilled with either of them. The opponent's deck can just play an Emrakul, so I'm not too keen on those cards. Meanwhile, Crocusing Emrakul isn't exactly the best either, but if he show and tells it in, like super early, that could be a thing. Maybe I should be playing Spheres. I think Crossing Grip's better. I don't think I want to cut all my Punishing Fires, because like if he needles Thespian Stage, if he gets rid of the Dark Depths combo somehow, I want to have a backup win condition. That's what that is, even if there are only two of them. But the way we win the game is just locking the opponent out like we did there. I think that's going to be the most common win. Yeah, we can keep this. Turn one, Mox Diamond, discard Maze of Ith, and then we get to decide whether we're going to crop rotation or gamble or... or both. Like, we can turn one Loam again if that's something that we wanted to do. I don't hate it. I don't hate just porting him here, too. I think I'm going to... yeah, I can play the Thespian Stage, float, sag it with crop rotation. Oh, I can't loam on turn one. What am I thinking? Just gonna port him, I guess. Not the best, because he already has top in play. Pretty okay with that. Yeesh. Really want to use this to like get Wasteland and such, but I think I have to get like Wooded Foothills. God, this is miserable. I'm sure I had a better turn there somewhere. Dredge back loam. Cast it, get back some things. Probably just port him. Dredge back loam again. Gamble for exploration, maybe. I could tap this port. No, that doesn't get me anywhere. What did he tutor for? Oh, he tutored for the Heath. That's interesting. Short on mana, I guess. Can wasteland then. He's got a crop rotation here. Okay. Rest in peace, I guess. So we have some options here. We can get Wasteland, play it, waste him, port him. Be in good shape. We could also get Dark Depths. Just go for the W. Both fine lines. What are the benefits? The benefits of getting Wasteland. The benefit of getting Wasteland here is that if I actually discard the Wasteland, then it's a much better card to loan back. Whereas if I get Dark Depths in it and I have to bin it, then I'm probably just going to play port, pass, double port him, and wait to like loan plus activate stage next turn. I guess that's a fine backup play. All right. So the danger here is that he has an answer in crop rotation. Still gonna go for it, of course. I don't take this line if I'm not gonna go for it. And then if he can disrupt it, then I just untap and gamble for Wasteland. Start wasting it. Gigi, he says, love your content. Thanks, Mr. Zarito. Appreciate it.